Hey guys, how you doing? Welcome back to Sim UK. I have got maybe a little surprise for you guys today. This is Naval Action. You've probably seen a few snippets on my channel every now and then. I tried to get myself into this hardcore a little while back, and all that happened was I got my very first ship, which is a very small little ship, and I picked a port that I was heading for, trying to do a job. And I sailed across the ocean for about 7 hours, fell asleep, and just ended up basically crashing into the shore, and that was the end of me. Didn't go very well. Well, today I'm going to do it slightly differently because I have Spike with me. Hello, Spike. How you doing, my friend?
Mate, I'm doing really good. You have the best recording voice ever.
Oh, thank you so much, sir. Spike is an absolute master at this.
No, I'm not.
He's a master at arms. He's going to teach me everything I need to know about this game so that I can actually do it properly. So, Spike, thank you so much for doing this. And I wish you all the luck in the world.
It's going to crash and burn heavily then.
So, I'm in the player creation zone. Tell me what to do, mate.
Make your character. Just call him what you want to call him. Pick your country, which is going to be pirates, and then join.
Pirates. And then create. And start. Okay, so we're in the PVE server, is that correct?
That's correct.
Do you have DLC for this game?
I do.
Do you have a lot of DLC?
I do. Well, not a lot, but I'll tell you what I've got.
Do you have HMS Victory?
No. I spent a little bit of money on this, so I've just got the Admiralty Connection DLC.
What is that when it's at home?
Gives me 16 extra warehouses in every port, 10 extra docks for my vessels, so I can get 10 extra ships, and 5 extra building permits, which lets me build more things that will help for crafting boats and things like that.
Okay, well, that sounds pretty positive. Sounds a little bit like pay to win.
A little bit.
Yeah.
And for some reason,
we'll ignore that.
They gave me the Trim Comely DLC. I think when they reduced the price of the game to £15.
Yeah, I was reading just a moment ago that they made it free for people at some point, but currently they're charging £30. The Trim Comely, you've just enlightened me. The Trim Comely would have been Nelson's flagship after HMS Victory, had he survived long enough.
War carried on, basically. The war ended when it was still being built.
Right.
Yeah.
Oh, so he didn't die. It wasn't when he died then. It wasn't.
No.
Okay, so it was before that. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, so I've learned something new today. Two. Lots of new things. So I've got my ship, mate. Well, I call it a ship. It's smaller than the house.
Hearty, lad. Right, me hearty.
It looks a little bit like the ship that you would put on a ship to escape if your ship was sinking.
All right, yeah. Yeah, that makes sense.
Yeah, very nice there.
In the bottom left-hand corner of your awesome monitor...
Yes.
There is a chat window.
Yes.
In the top right-hand corner of that chat window, there is what looks like a square with arrows going in 4 different directions.
Yes.
Yes, if you click that and drag it out to your right, it'll expand the box a bit.
Right.
So you can see all the chat windows.
Learning already.
I just figured that out myself in the last 30 seconds.
don't say that. You're the expert.
Can you see Nation?
Yes.
Yeah, if you click Nation and type in the text at the bottom, type hello or put 07 or whatever. That'll help me massively. Here we go. Right. So, we are now going to get a group invitation.
Captain Fulgrim has invited you to his battle group. Do you accept? Aye. Oh, cool.
To add you as a friend.
Right, first question. Is there any way I can make the UI bigger?
That I have no clue about.
Let me go up here, see if I can figure that out.
Yes, top left of the chat, if you click the very end thing, it says small, large and medium. Maybe that helps you. Yes, you can make the chat bigger.
Where did you... Top left?
Top. So the chat window itself, where I told you to expand it.
Yeah.
If you go all the way along to the left-hand side, there's a, there's an arrow and then there's like a weird looking symbol. Looks like an A in it, I think.
Oh, that's just for text.
That's just to make your text a bit bigger.
Let me just have a look in the options, general.
You might be able to do
graphics. Interface scale port. Look at that. Oh yeah, that's bigger. That's bigger. I'll just put everything on maximum because I'm playing on 4K and everything's tiny. Oh, well, that made everything smaller again. That was weird. Okay. I think that's helped a bit. Yeah. Okay. For now, that's good enough. I can see. Let's see. What next, Captain?
Just looking at the ship ranks a second. Google is your friend when it comes to this game. It really is.
See, all I did was sail in that direction for about 7 hours. I didn't meet any other ships. I didn't find land.
What ship are we in?
I am in...
We're on a basic cutter, aren't we? Right, so it's the seventh rating. Right, so we want... First question to you then, mate. Do you want to go blow somebody up? Or do you want to make a little bit of coin and then we'll go blow somebody up?
Let's do the second thing. So I can have a bit of practice.
Make a bit of coin and blow somebody up.
Yeah. Yeah.
Right. Okay. So right at the bottom of the screen on your UI, there's a bunch of nice looking symbols.
There are.
You want the open book one. If you mouse over it, it says port quest.
Yep.
Okay. And then you've got three types of available missions to do. Seasons and you can do events and then you journal to blah blah blah, but if you go to missions and then there's three types. Is it economy, battle and conquest?
Yes,
you can ignore the conquest for the minute because there's no way we're going to be good enough for that kind of stuff. So if we do the economy, you'll have six missions to do, three cargo, three passenger. Yeah.
Okay.
Right, so let's have a look at the passenger missions. So if you click the first passenger delivery, where's it going to?
Islet or islet.
Perfect. Right, perfect. The second one, is it
Jeremiah?
Jeremiah. And then the last one should be Tribune. Tribune?
Tiburon, yeah, I'd say so.
Perfect, right. Okay, so the more money, the further away it is. So let's do a small one. So let's do the first one. So we're going to go to Islet. But before you take the mission, hit your M button.
Ooh. Okay.
And get your sexy map up.
That is a sexy ass map. Oh, it goes all the way up as well.
Yeah, I know. It goes pretty high up, mate. This is. I'm pretty sure this is actual square for square footage.
1-to-1 scale.
I think this is 1-to-1. I'm not 100% sure. Now,
this
if you
beautiful.
Zoom in, if you zoom in on the nice circle where it says Mortimer Town in the middle of the map, when you open your map up, you see like a white circle.
Oh yes.
Yes, and it says Mortimer Town.
Yeah. Oh, I see Islet. I do.
On the other side, we can take a short little trip round the coast and drop off and make 14K. What do you think?
Sounds good to me.
All right, so take that mission. Confirm it.
Is this passenger we're doing?
Yes, this is passenger we're doing. Right, and then just to make sure, you on your basic cutter, you've got four icons. A gear cog, a hammer and chisel, a tricorn, and a barrel.
A tricorn? Check you out with the correct terminology.
No, yes. Right? Yes. So click on your barrel just to make sure that you've got your passengers on board.
I do.
Now, if you mouse over them, in real time, you have 24 hours to deliver these passengers. So you can bugger off to bed. You could come back the next day and still be able to bring them to where they want to be.
Right. So it's a little bit like air hauler in that sense.
A little bit. A little bit. Now,
like it.
There are boats that you can get up, that you can work your way up to that don't take massive amount of time. And they're called, I'm going to get the name wrong here. How you pronounce it? Indian men boat. It's a cargo ship.
Right.
And it carries quite a bit of stuff, and everybody always gets one of them for shipping cargo around the map and things like that.
Roger.
You can actually go just dead fast before we clear off. The scales at the bottom of the screen, fourth one along from the left, is the shop. If you click and open that up, and you go to resources at the top, and then go trading.
Yeah.
You can take livestock, salted pork, or Yorkshire puddings.
Yorkshire puddings.
Now, there's 110 in stock, 7 salted pork and 26 livestock. And if you... I don't know how broken this is. It gets a bit crazy. If you open your map up and then click more in the top left-hand corner...
Yeah.
And then, and I'm overloading your brain here a little bit.
A little bit.
And then if you click Trader Tool.
Oh, yeah.
And then type in Yorkshire.
Yorkshire.
Yorkshire pudding should come up.
Certainly does.
You can do the slide, the slider. There's like a slider underneath European Central, Europe Central Goods.
Got you.
And you bring the slider down, and it'll bring it down to Mortimer Town, where you are right now. And it's selling for 94. Which is less than what you're buying it for, so you'll be at a loss if you just buy it and sell it here. So
makes sense.
Take the slider up like a little bit. How much are, did we say 94?
Yeah, Islet.
110, right? Islet's buying it for 114.
Is they're selling it for 114?
I think that's the price that you would get them for.
Yeah. So how do you know how much they're going to buy them for? I guess you don't until you get there.
Yeah. This is where I think it's like a bit dodgy. Like, if you keep taking the slider up, you're trying to beat 110.
Is that how much it's going to cost us, 110?
110 is how much we're buying it for. So
if they sell it for 94... Oh, I see. I can sell it for 94... But to buy it's 110. So at Islet, we can sell it for 114.
Yeah.
So we're going to make four coins.
Four coins for every Yorkshire pudding that we get, which is a bit crap. But
money.
But if you take the slider up a little bit, I'm just showing you how the trader works. We're not going to do it. If you take the slider up and then you click sell at the top until you get the highest amount coming from top to bottom. Then I've got I'm not very good at pronouncing these names. I've got Lagoon Niger, which is 182 kilometers away, and they're selling for 589.
Wow.
If I click the thing on that, that's literally in Cuba, just up the road. Not far. We could take them Yorkshires and go and sell them there. We could do the islet thing, come back, grab the auctions and go over and sell that if you wanted to, but the sale will be a little bit longer and we'd... I don't know. It's up to you.
Well, let's just take some Yorkshire puddings to Islet and make a small profit, like a teeny tiny profit.
Is that what you want?
Yeah, just so I can see what it's like to buy and sell stuff.
Okay. So let's... The downside is we haven't got any money. You're looking in the right-hand corner. We've got no cash at all. We're thief and no money at all.
Right, so Roger.
We might as well just go and take these passengers and say bugger.
Let's do it. Okay, let's do it.
Just click leave port and we'll and I'll see you in the open sea.
Right. I don't even remember the controls. Is it WASD?
WASD, yeah.
Simple as that. I haven't even got any cannons. What happens if we get attacked on the way?
We won't. It's PVE server.
What, the enemy, the AI don't attack you ever?
Nope.
What?
Not on the PVE server.
So boring.
Yeah, you just attack them, that's it.
There should be pirates.
There's no risk on PVE. There's plenty of risk on PvP. Like, you just get ganked by a flipping beast.
Sounds to me like they need a third server.
In the middle,
where the AI might attack you possibly if you're in the wrong place at the wrong time.
Tell me when you're on the open sea.
Are you in the open sea already?
I am, yeah.
Oh, why is my PC running so slow?
She's fast, is my computer.
You do have a very fast computer, don't you? What is your you got an Intel? What have you got? I've forgotten.
12K processor.
i9 12K. See, I've got an i9 9900, so I'm not that far behind you. But I suspect my hard drive that I'm running my games on is like an old, you know, the big chunky buggers.
Oh yeah.
I think it's one of them.
When I got my computer, I went to put my other hard drive in for extra space, and I opened my PC tower up and stuff to put it in, and I couldn't find the hard drive anywhere. Seriously, I was bricking it.
It's one of the new ones, right?
It says it on... You're going to teach me something now, aren't you? I looked at the receipt and everything, and the receipt said the hard drive was there. They'd sold me it, they packed it up and everything, and I was like, where the hell is this hard drive? And I still don't know to this day where the hard drive is. Can you enlighten me?
Yeah. So is it an M2, yeah?
I haven't got a clue what an M2 is.
So it's the new... It's like, you know, RAM?
Yeah.
It kind of looks like that. It looks like a stick of RAM, except there's a hard drive, and it's super fast, and it gets hot, but you can put, like, heat sinks on the back of it, so it's very efficient.
It looks like a stick of RAM. What the hell?
Yeah, it looks a bit like a stick of RAM, and it goes straight onto the motherboard. Usually, it's under or around where your graphics card goes.
It's plugged into the motherboard, Mel. Near the graphics card, Mike's just told me.
But it may have a heatsink over the top of it, so you won't actually be able to see it.
So I won't be able to see it, right?
Okay. So the heatsink is a very thin, very small bit of metal, basically.
Are you still loading in?
No, well, I don't know. I've got server selection again. Is that weird?
Oh, you've been kicked.
Oh, I got kicked. That's probably why it took so long then. Sending crash report. Okay, back in. Does this happen a lot? It's never happened to me before, I think.
It never happened to me before.
Okay, I'm just lucky. There's creating new bugs. That's comforting. I'm in the sea.
Okay. I got you. Right.
Is that you?
Yeah, I'm going to group you again.
Okay, awesome.
Because we dropped group for some reason.
Has that undone all of my settings? I think it has. I don't know. Right, carry on, sir.
Right, are you ready?
I'm ready.
Right, so you have to press W several times to get your full sails out. There you go.
Which way are we heading?
To the left.
To the left? You mean to port, yes?
I don't know what these things are.
You always pass the port to the left.
Okay.
And port also has the same number of letters in as the word left.
Okay, so in the bottom right-hand corner, you'll see your compass, and then you'll see which way the wind's blowing as well.
Ah, yes, okay, yeah, I see that.
Yeah.
Well, bloody hell, we are travelling at some speed, aren't we?
Has it been a long time since you've played this game?
Yes.
So when you may have played it when I wanted to play it, when you were sailing at proper speed.
Oh, they've changed it.
They changed it because a lot of people were complaining it takes a long time to get anywhere.
So no. Yes, why?
Particularly disappointing. This is one of the. This is my biggest pet hater about the game.
This is horrible.
It is horrible because it's super fast, isn't it? However, you can simulate it if you want and drop your sails and make yourself go slower.
But doesn't that just make time completely irrelevant? Oh, that's annoying as hell.
Yeah, I know. It's one of my biggest disappointments about the game.
And you can't turn it off?
Nope.
It's ridiculous.
I was so pumped to take ages to get anywhere, and then this happened, and I could have cried.
They desperately need a third server, because this is not what it was like last time I played.
No.
This is horrible.
Yeah. The combat's about the only decent thing about it. Because you'll get to wherever you want to be in no time, and I purposely didn't tell you about this because I thought that you'd
put me off
at the slow.
I'm not getting any of the sailing sort of kicks that I got the last time I played.
I mean, if you take yourself down to slow.
Yeah.
Which is the first sail up. We're only going 5 knots. Does that feel? Now you need to go down one more. Does that feel like it did when you played it, or?
Yeah, that's more what I was expecting.
Yeah. I mean, I don't mind honestly playing like this. If that's what you want to do, I'm quite happy to sail around like this if you want to sail around like this.
Wow.
I know. It's bitterly disappointing, isn't it?
Kind of eliminates a large part of the game. Okay. I mean, this is still quite nippy, I think.
Yeah, we're going 7 knots. Well, I am. I don't know about yourself.
I'm doing 7 knots, yeah. Bang on.
Yeah. Oh, I've accidentally pressed B and started fishing.
I didn't know you could fish in this game.
Yeah, press B and your sailors will just randomly catch fish for you and you can sell them.
Do they eat them as well?
No, I don't know. They might do, I'm not sure.
Because you've got to provide food for your crew, right?
Yeah, you do, yeah. Yeah, yeah. Also, the game also warns you when you come out of port and stuff that you haven't got any cannons and things like that. Or at least it should do.
That flag on the top of your ship is weird.
Yeah, you've got a weird flag on top of your ship as well. I think it might be a grouped flag.
So, I'm not being funny. Why not just attach a flag to the top of the mast?
Yeah.
Wouldn't that look a lot better?
Uh-huh.
Okay, so I you know, already I'm starting to see why people hate the devs.
Yep, yep.
Because clearly they're not interested in what people think, or they don't spend more than 3 seconds thinking about what the best way to do something is.
Nope.
Very annoying.
That fortress off to your port side there. See what I did there, port side. We want to be heading round that, mate.
Yeah.
Let's just turn into port a little bit.
I was just doing that as he said it, in fact.
Good lad.
This is nice. Yeah. This is nice and casual and...
This is what you want to do, Mike. I'm completely happy to do it.
Yeah. Mate. I don't mind one up, actually.
Right.
What sort of speed is that?
I've got a half speed, then.
Because that still feels reasonable, doesn't it?
Half speed's taking me at 8 knots at the moment, 9 knots, 10.
Yeah, I'm squeezing out 10, 11.
Yeah, just at 11.
You see, the thing is, when you're like sailing, you've got to be aware of your surroundings and whatnot. But you can take your eye off the ship for a minute. But at the speed we were travelling at a minute ago, if you take your eye off the ship for a second, you're going to crash.
To tell you the truth, I've actually got myself into open water, set it in the direction I wanted to go, buggered off and made a cup of tea, and the ship's still been fine.
Okay.
All right, this is us.
What's us?
Turning here.
Just right.
It's just here.
God, that's super close.
Yep.
It'd be nice as well if you could actually... Harbour the ship.
Yeah.
That would be nice.
You sail into the jetty, and then you'll get an icon come up at the top of the screen. You just click it, and then it'll pot, and then it'll teleport you into the port. Right. There we go. And it's mooring up.
Oh my god, the boat stops awfully quickly, doesn't it?
Yep.
Like, instantly.
Right, let me know when you're on the port screen.
Yep, I am.
Right, so click your cargo hold, your barrel, again.
Unload me barrel of passengers.
let's just do it normally.
You'd think they complain, wouldn't you, being shoved in a barrel the whole way over?
If you click the book at the bottom of the screen, sorry.
I lied, I'm not actually on the port yet.
Okay. When you get there, click the book.
Okay. Click the book, not the barrel.
Yeah.
Yep.
Yeah. And then go to journal on the far right.
Journal.
And then you'll see passenger delivery, how much it's worth, and then just click deliver, and then click confirm, and then you'll have 14k in your top left hand corner.
That is so easy.
Yeah, it's dead simple, isn't it? So if we open the journal up again and go to missions, we can do another passenger delivery. There's one there for 25k to Parrot K. There's one there to 22k to somewhere where I can't pronounce.
How much money do we need for some cannons?
I need to... Right. If you open up your cogwheel, it'll open up your ship. You'll actually should see that you've got 12 3-pounder base guns already in your boat. So we can't get any more in the ship. So we've already got... We have actually got cannons on board.
But we can't see them?
No.
Weird.
You see them when you get into a battle sequence.
But not before.
Yeah, not before, yeah. Yep, yep.
These devs are making some very strange decisions, in my opinion.
Cutting corners quite a bit, aren't they?
Yeah.
Right, do you wanna do a battle?
Well, I don't really know how you get into battles. If it's like the tutorial, then could we be doing a mission, and if we see an opportunity, we take it sort of situation?
Yeah, so you've got two options what you could do. You can literally go out there, find a boat kind of right around about your rank. Google is your friend, finding out what ranks the ships are, because it's not very explanatory in the actual game, which is annoying as hell. And we can go and sink the ship, and chances are we might get some loot from it, we might not. Or We can go.
Can we steal the ship?
No. We can only
do that
in PvP.
You are kidding me.
There's a lot of benefits to going on the PvP server. The downside is the minute you leave port, there's probably going to be somebody waiting there with a Trim Comely or an HMS Victory or something like that just to gank a noob. And
right.
What they'll do is you'll get out of port, they'll get right near you, and they'll initiate a battle, and you've got no chance of ignoring it. Can't escape. And you'll get portaled into a battle with them, and all you can do is either die or run like hell. And chances are they'll catch you up and just blow you up. Because what they do is do the old classic naval strategy of sailing from port to starboard over and over again. And each time they turn, they'll shoot you with the left side, and then they'll shoot you with the right side. And they'll just keep repeating, rinse and repeating that over and over again. And they'll just deck you. And it destroys the game for me. I like to be casual. I don't like PvP. Well, that's just me. Or you can go into your missions tab. You go to... So you open your book up and you open up the battle side, and you'll see there's a bunch of kill missions and a bunch of hunt missions and a bunch of search and destroy missions for you to do. We're in tier 7 boats, so we could do the one there and earn 200 doubloons, which is stuff that we actually really do need for the game.
So ranks, what's that, rank 6, kill 250?
Yeah, or... no, so ranks, if you do a rank 6 boat, which is not a good idea in the boat that we're in now, we'll be rewarded 250 doubloons.
Right.
So what we just earned just then is a different currency from dropping them passengers off, and they're called reals.
Okay.
Reals. So if we did a tier 7 mission, a rank 7 mission, we'd earn 200.
So hang on. A rank 7 is lower than a rank 6 because...
Yes.
A ship of the line is a rank 1. Is
rank
that right?
Rank 1 is the best boat you can get in the game.
Right. Okay.
So
okay.
Better
Roger.
The ship.
So the fact that there's two of us doesn't put the advantage in our favour for a level 6.
Puts it fully in our favour because it'll be 2v1.
Right.
Because we'll be fighting one ship.
Okay.
We won't be fighting two. So what'll happen is we'll take the mission, and then it'll tell us on the map where to go and find this guy. And then we basically go to that point, and then we get portaled into a battle, and then we kill him.
Got you.
Or he kills us. But 9 times out of 10, I kill him.
So can we go for the rank 6 for 500, as soon as there's two of us?
You will be faced off against either one of the following boats. And there's quite a few. So we'd have a brig, which has 16 guns.
And we've got 14 between us, right?
We've got 12.
12 between us. 12 each?
12 each, right?
Okay.
We could go up against the Mercury, which has 20. We could go up against a Navy brig that has 18, a Rattlesnake, which has 18, a Snow, which has 22, a Prince something, which has 20, a Mortar brig, which has 12, an Agrara, which has 20, a Heavy Rattlesnake that has 26, and that's it.
Okay.
But you've also got to remember their armour. Their side armor and things like that. We've got 2,000, and they've got anything from between 2,800 to 3,700.
And our penetration is 125. Something
like that, yeah.
125 centimeters? Millimeters.
To be honest with you, and see where you're coming from because of the amount of money that we would earn. But as starting players and me coming back to this,
you think we should go for the like a practice run?
The easy okay. shit to start off with.
Okay, that's fine by me. You're the Capitano.
Right, so if I take the mission, then we can, you just follow me and we'll go and do it, yeah?
Right, okay. So I don't have to take the mission as well, like last time?
No.
Okay.
No.
Cool bananas.
If you did, then we'd be doing it twice, which would mean that we would earn twice as much coin.
Okay.
You know, it's just something to look at for the future. But if we go for it now, then right, let's have a quick look at the shop.
Excuse me. You heard me burping then? Do apologize.
Right, if you go to the shop and go to consumables and buy 5 rum, that'll help with healing that'll help ease the soldier's pain when they're fixing him up during the battle. So you can pop that sort of thing when stuff's going down. And then there should be some repair kits somewhere. I'm not sure if they do repair kits here. We might have to go around the other side. Or just say screw it and go for it. Just got guns and stuff on in there. There's no. Did you get some rum?
I did. Rum's in the bag.
Okay. You gotta make sure that it's in your ship as well. I'm gonna send this to the warehouse, and that's warehouse.
So we've got 12 cannons.
Yeah, 6 on each side.
So we could upgrade our cannons to 32-pound medium guns, and...
Will they fit on the boat, though?
How would I know that?
I have not got a clue. it's a trial and error thing.
Right. So we might end up buying cannons that don't fit on our ship.
Exactly, yeah. Right. Yeah, that's the...
So if I bought one...
That's the problem. You could try it.
Buy 32-pound medium gun for 1,060 reals. Okay, I bought one. How would I swap it over?
Open your ship up. Hotkey Z.
Okay, yep.
Yeah, and then press G, which should bring up your warehouse, and the cannon should be in there.
See it, yeah.
Yeah. Click and drag it and see if it'll go over the top of the gun.
No.
No? Right, okay.
That's too big, the cannon.
Yeah, the way I see it is we save up and go for either a rattlesnake or a snow as our next ship for combat purposes. Getting hold of a heavy rattlesnake could be quite difficult. They have the best armor in the game at that rank of 6, and they've also got 26 guns on board, which I think is the most. So the next ship down from that, in my estimations for affording things, is probably the actual rattlesnake itself, not the heavy. Yeah, it's Again, it's trial and error.
Okay, I've just tried a 32-pounder, an 18-pounder, and a 12-pounder, and none of them are going on.
All right, that's fair enough, mate.
So I think we're stuck with the 3-pounders for now. Okay, right. Capitano.
You ready?
Ready, ready, ready.
I'm absolutely bricking myself here.
Fear not, you've got me. Oh, hang on. I don't think I put the rum on board.
Oh, okay. You're still in the boat? Are you still in the port?
I'm still in the port, yeah.
Okay, so go open up your warehouse.
Yeah.
And then you should be able to right-click on it and deliver it to your hold.
Oh, right-click on it, sorry.
Yeah.
Send to hold, yeah?
Yeah.
Cool. Where does that show up, then? How do I see what's in my hold?
When you're in the real world or when you're in port?
When I'm in port.
You press the barrel again. Press the barrel again.
Oh, I see it. Okay, cool.
Yeah, and then when you're in the real world, you press H for hold, and then you'll see the rum.
Okay.
All right.
Excellent. I'm ready when you are, boss.
All right, well, I'm out of the port, and I'm just waiting for you to come out.
Entering the open world now. I'm quite excited about this.
I'm bricking myself, but...
Can I accidentally sink you?
No.
Good.
Okay. I don't think so.
We'll probably find out soon enough.
Yeah. I've forgotten how to control the boat and everything, so this is going to be, when it comes to combat, so this is going to be absolutely hilarious. So we're going to starboard this time. That's where the guy is. Are we going full pelt, or are we going like...
Go full pelt. Go for it.
Yeah, all right. No problem.
Actually, level 3 is not too bad either, is it? Level 4... Am I at max speed?
In your compass, does it say full?
It does, yeah. It's so small, though, I can barely see it, to be fair.
Max speed, then, mate. Max speed with the wind behind you is like 21 knots.
Yeah, I think you're going a little bit faster than me, possibly.
22
yeah, I'm up to 21 knots now, yeah.
It's over this way somewhere.
How do you know it's over that way somewhere, just out of interest?
I've got a really big...
be careful now.
I've got a really big couple of cutlasses clashing with each other.
Oh, what? Something you can see on screen?
There she is. I can see it. She's over there. Kill mission. There we go.
Do I need to be near you, or will it just pick me up?
What I want to do is I want to get to where it is, and then I'm going to park my boat up. I'm going to stop, and then I'll click join as group, and we'll both get portaled in.
Right. Oh, I see it. I see the...
Can you see the indicator?
I see something white in the distance.
All right, that'll be this is going to make you laugh even more. So if you click it, it's called a wind zone, and it lasts for 11 minutes, and it'll give you a 37% more bonus to your sails, so you can go even faster.
Right.
Ridiculous, right?
It's just... I don't know what kind of game this is. It's confusing me.
Park it up. Drop sail. We can't crash into each other either. We'll just go straight.
Hang on a minute. You can turn circles when you've got no...
Yeah.
Oh, man.
It's ridiculous, isn't it? All right, are you ready?
I'm ready. Well, I think I'm ready. I don't know.
Joining this group. Are you entering combat?
Yes.
Awesome. Here we go.
This is it.
Let's go kill this guy.
Game on. I've completely forgotten the controls for this, so you may have to...
So have I.
Okay. We'll figure it out. Or we'll die trying, one or the other.
Yeah, right, I'm in.
I've got to change my hard drive.
What? I've got some bad news for you.
What?
There's two boats here.
That's good news.
This is going to be hilarious.
Double trouble.
Battle starts in 10 seconds. Are you winning the game?
No.
All right.
There's entering combat.
3, 2, 1. Game started. Have an hour and a half to kill them.
What, of real time?
Yes, of real time.
Can it really genuinely take an hour and a half?
No. It does take quite a while to blow a boat up.
Yeah, I can imagine. I can't believe you can't board them and take the ship. I think that's outrageous.
You can actually go and, like, fight them.
Right, okay. But you just can't keep the ship.
You can't take the ship, no.
That's ridiculous, because there's so much money.
They're bearing down on us right now. Am I still waiting for you to come in the game?
It still says entering combat. I don't know what to do.
Oh, no. Oh, no, we're good.
Oh, I see. What? I'm in.
All right, full sail. Get your sails right up, mate. Let's go. They're right in front of us.
So we're going straight at them?
We're going to go straight at them and then ball them from the... If you hold down right click, if you press right click, depending on which way you're looking, you'll get into the cannon mode. And then you've got to, like, raise it. If you raise it up, then you'll go higher. If you lower it down, you go lower.
Roger.
And then press space bar to fire.
So who are we going to hit? Westbrook.
I'm going to shoot Westbrook. If you can give him a broadside from your port side. Now,
are we doing an instant turnaround and come back on them the other side?
Yeah, that's what we'll try to do. Now, you can see the detail on your boat a lot more now if you zoom in, can't you?
Yeah.
Which is nice. And the boats are sailing quite nicely as well. Right, getting ready to line him up.
Oh, he's having a go at you, isn't he?
No, he's shooting you, mate, I think.
No, he's aimed at you, sir.
Did he?
This one's coming at me. Away the lads!
I hit his sails. I'm gonna shoot the little guy from the other side.
That was some pretty poor shooting.
Right, I'm turning.
Isn't there a way you can change? Like the order in which your guns fire or something.
If you press Q and E, you can just to let you know, you can change the sail to catch the wind. Just to catch the wind when you turn. I'm gonna get Z round as well. I am squandering myself in the water here. Right, here we go. Getting back up to speed. Where's my speed? There we go, 8 knots, that's better. Right. Give him a taste of my kind of broadsides. There's all twice it. I need to get a reload, so I'm gonna have to turn and get my port side in on him. Tense this, isn't it?
Rather. Oh, we came awfully close there.
How are you doing? See ya.
Come on, turn, sir.
Oh, look at all that smoke off the cannon fire.
How do I know when I'm ready to fire again?
It's the lights up if it's fully turned at the bottom.
Oh, I see it, yeah.
That makes any sense to you.
Yeah, I've figured it out.
Or
I filled in the gaps, it's all good.
Good lad.
I think I may have possibly missed him there.
Clipped his sails a couple of times. I'm gonna have to get on to the other guy. Turn.
That's not what we were looking for. Oh, I'm into the wind.
Yeah, turn your sails opposite direction as fast as you possibly can.
I actually took some hits that time for the first time.
Got some great hits on that other ship there. Brilliant hits on him. Got four hits on him that time.
Is there any way of knowing how much damage you're doing to a ship?
Yeah, if you look at them, if you kind of look in their direction, you'll see them in the top left-hand, top right-hand corner. If that makes sense to you.
Yeah, I got it completely.
Good. Are you enjoying yourself?
I love this bit. This bit is super cool.
This bit's super cool, isn't it?
You got one ship coming right up your jacksie, sir.
Yeah, yeah. I got it. You're all right. I'm gonna. Oh, he's turning right into me. You are gonna taste my flipping wrath, mate. I tell you. Oh, look at that beautiful stuff.
Where do you think you're going?
Starting to get used to the controls again now. Back in the old days. It's tearing me apart on my left hand side though.
I really don't know if I'm hitting this guy properly or not sometimes.
If you look right at
the This is the bit I need to practice, I think.
If you look right at the very top of the screen, it'll tell you what you're hitting. If you make the connection.
Oh yeah, hull and sails, okay.
Hull and sails, yeah, yeah. Yeah, so my guy's left hand side's nearly gone.
You're doing a better job than me then.
Well, he's over halfway gone. I'm waiting for a reload.
Pretty awful. I think I hit his sails.
Done, lads. Excellent sailing. Turn it more. I took out his cannon. I've got leaks. I've got crew killed there. 5 hits. Beautiful stuff. Sorry, I'll clear that a lot if I'm hitting you.
I didn't hit him at all.
Feel free to do so yourself.
What's that?
Declare your hits and stuff on that.
Okay, yeah, yeah. If I actually get any, I will.
This is a lot more fun playing this with somebody rather than playing it on your own.
I can imagine. Oh, I hit his mast. I like that.
You get one hit on him.
fits sails and his mast again.
You at the minute, so that's a nice little distraction away from me. I mean, nothing. I'm nice, aren't I?
How's your ship doing? No problems?
Oh, he's nearly gone here. See if we can get some shots off him. Oh, good lad. Well shot, mate. Well shot.
I got one in the hull. That was
well
it.
Well done, Mike. Now it's better than nothing. Your ship's looking a hell of a lot better than mine. Sorry. Your ship's a hell of a lot better than mine, mate.
That was better. Three hull, one crew. Five hull, one crew. That's a bit more like it. And I'm ahead of him as well, so I don't think he can do anything.
And another crew member, so he's nearly gone. Let's try and sink this guy, mate. Let's get on him. Get on him. Get on him. Mr. Squibs. That's your new nickname, Mr. Squibs. Get him, Mr. Squibs.
Poor hull. Oh, I took some hits that time.
Languishing in the bloody water. I don't know if I've got the sails down right. But I don't know. I just made it up.
Got some good hits on him there as well.
I'm playing a lot better than I thought I would.
What happens if I hit him? I lost my front mast, I think.
Damage to your ship.
Yeah.
His ship.
Definitely took some damage there. That was silly. I shouldn't have done that. Duly noted.
I'm about to get broadside from the southern boat. But it's fine. Well, we need to get this other boat sunk, mate.
Oh, I think. And maybe.
On sailing. See if we can broadside the hell out of this guy here.
I'm a bit dead in the water.
They are. We've trashed the hell out of him.
No, I am.
Oh, mate. No, that's not good. I need you. don't die.
Oh yeah, my ship's in a real bad state. I've just realised my icon in the top right hand corner.
Some massive hits off this guy. Oh no, we're battling. I've never done this before. Me and him are doing boarding actions.
Get on and win it. Oh no, my ship's fine. My ship's in the top left-hand corner.
Yeah, your ship's in the top left-hand corner.
Why can't I sail then? What's going on? What am I doing wrong here?
Try turning your sails with either Q and Z or E and C.
Oh, I'd forgotten about this bit. Yeah. Alrighty, we're back in the game. Fire! Oh yeah, we got some seriously good hits on him there.
Yeah, morale. This guy's chip stuff is morale is at zero now. There, did we win? can't we want? Successfully boarded him. I think we beat him.
Well, that's good.
Come and help me with this guy here.
Definitely having some forward momentum problems. I seem to be going in reverse, which is quite an achievement.
Sail sorted out here. I'm not going anywhere fast. I've got to get used to this. I think he's definitely scuppered. I think we've scuppered that guy, which is good. We've just got the one boat to deal with now. Oh, Captain Fulgrim sank. What? Oh. He's gone. Definitely beat him. Like my shooting just over the front of your ship there.
Yeah, it's made me a little bit nervous.
Oh, it's pretty dope though, wasn't it?
It's pretty dope. Yeah, it's pretty dope.
Turn to your left, mate. Sorry. Well, as soon as you get into the wind, you want to turn your sails right on the edge of the Q and Z. To get full speed momentum out of the turn.
I think I got on the wrong side.
And then we can pump him like this one.
Need a bit of practice with the sails.
Turn to my right. Coming in for a lineup on you, mate. Get ready to shoot him.
Oh yeah, I see him.
See the other boat sinking?
Yeah.
This guy's full of holes, man.
Yeah. I've licked him pretty good. I'm doing bloody reverse manoeuvres again. Took out two of his cannons and one of his crew.
You're getting better, mate.
Some of the shots are landing now.
Yep. Just takes practice. It'll also give us a bit of a report at the end who did the most damage and stuff like that, so...
Don't get upset if it's me.
No, I won't get upset if it's you. I'll be very proud of you if it's you.
I'll be very proud of me if it's me. There's nothing left of his ship at all, is there? The front end is...
It is
done for.
The front end is devastated. It sails all the way from over here. Can't shoot anymore, I don't want to hit you. Oh, it's coming on the other side. And it sails and it's massive. Yeah, we need to get his middle bar down now. So everything that we pump into him now is aimed at his mid, will be depleted off his middle bar. And the minute his middle bar's gone, he's dead.
What does the middle bar represent? The crew?
The bar represents like his hull and things like that, like his central core of his boat sort of deal. Shots. My rear's nearly gone, but I'm not too fussed about it.
My front. I took all the damage. I took as when I sailed into that boat.
Got him. You sank him. He's gone.
He's gone.
You got the kill. Yes, nice one, mate. Well done. But if you press escape now to leave, but okay. If you can sail near him.
Leave battle, sail, yeah.
If you sail now, don't. If you sail near him, and now sail near the other guy, we might be able to get some loot.
Oh, okay.
Problem is, I need to get some sailage. Come on, give me some speed. Thank you. May or may not be something near on him. On them. I'm not sure how you find out. Can't see anything on the sky. And my ship won't slow down either. So I think we'll be alright. I think we can just leave, mate. You want to press escape?
Yeah, can do.
Yeah,
right. Leave battle.
Press escape and click leave battle, and then you say yeah.
Okay. Oh, that was a success.
It was a rip-roaring success, actually. That was really good.
Next time I won't sail my boat straight into the back of the enemy. I've got 166 XP. Is that good?
Yeah, that's excellent. I got 219.
Very nice. Very nice. Okay.
That was a great success, that. Right. So if we go...
Oh, the front of my boat's fixed. That's random.
Random. So if we go to the northwestish and go back to Mortimer...
Roger that.
We can grab some Yorkshire puddings and go sell them if you want. Oh, no,
hey, if there's money in Yorkshire puddings, I'm up for it.
Go to Islip first, because that's where we got the mission from. So turn it around. My bad. Hey. Sorry. Just want to make sure that we go to the right place. So full turn, follow me. There you go, buddy. Good lad.
Yeah, the sailing side of things I should be pretty good at. I've got quite a bit of knowledge, let's say. Not necessarily hands-on experience, but technical knowledge.
For your first run out there, and I thought we did pretty well for a couple of nights.
I think we could have done a level 6, personally.
You do?
I do now. And maybe not on the first one, but now I feel confident that we could, yeah. So I was definitely laying some hits on him and not taking any back for most of that fight. Like I say, the biggest amount of damage I got was when I sailed into his arse.
Yeah, yeah.
I should have asked you what the damage would have been like before doing it instead of at the same time.
It's been a while since I've sailed into anybody. I can't remember if he took anybody. It's been a while since I've played combat in this.
What happens if we sail into each other? Is it the same situation?
I think the same situation would happen and we would take damage again with each other, yeah. Which is one of the reasons why I'm a bit sceptical about shooting... Oh, excuse me. Shooting into you, because I might hurt you.
Yeah.
Which is why I didn't do a full volley when I was shot just in front of you when he came in front of me. But it was a good combo because I pumped about 3 shots into him and then you banged about you banged a full volley into him, which was pretty sweet.
How do you know when you got a full volley? Is it that you get six? Oh, I get it. So if I get five, if I get six hull, that means I've all six of my cannons have hit him.
Exactly, yeah.
Yeah, okay.
How it works, mate.
Okay. That makes sense.
Let me know when you're in port.
I'm in port now.
You see the port screen?
I see the port screen. Journal. Oh, okay.
This is a bit where I'm quite... Right, I've claimed my reward. Up in the... this is where we do trial and error. You see the big gold coin that's next to your rank, which says thief and how much money you've got?
Yeah.
Yeah.
The money chest.
Yeah, if you click that and tell me if you've got any money in there.
Nope.
No, okay. So that's a case of you need to accept the mission at the same time as me.
Right, okay.
Let me try something. Where's your option? Okay.
Now, you're going to trade me half of your coinage.
I'm going to try to. Right, I'm going to remove that. I'm trying to split them, but it's not working at the moment. Split. Okay. No, it won't split. Damn it.
That's okay. There'll be other points. I can get coinage then. Not a problem.
Right. We need to... Oh, we can't.
Do we need to do repairs or anything like that?
No, apparently not. Mouse over the repair button. That is really disappointing. The ship is instantly repaired except crew for free after any battle.
Is that just this ship?
It might be just this ship.
Because it's a beginner's ship.
I'm kind of hoping that that's what it is.
Because that would be really disappointing if that isn't the case.
Oh, yes. Quit. I'm trying to find. There we go. Manage crew. Right. What I want you to do is, I want you to press the two anchors next to the two tankers at the bottom of the screen. And it'll bring up your navy. And then top left-hand corner of that screen, you'll see manage crew.
Yep.
If you then click your slider and slide it all the way to the end, and it'll say 40 out of 40.
Yeah.
Apply it, and then you'll be at full crew again.
Okay.
Right, should we sail round to Mortimer Town, pick up some Yorkie puds and get them sold and make a bit of coin?
Let's do it.
All right. Leaving Portland.
Let the bass kick. Let the bass kick. Let the